Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn about types of chemical reactions from 9th class 7th chapter. This is P. Pranita, PGT Chemistry from TSMS Nagasamudrala. So there are learning objectives. You need to understand the chemical reactions and differentiate between the four types of reactions. You should identify the products of the reaction. You know what is meant by reactant and products, isn't it? Reactants are in left side of the arrow mark and products are right side of the arrow mark. Now we will know about chemical reaction. Children, already you know, according to law of conservation of mass, atoms are neither created nor destroyed during the chemical reaction. Chemical reaction is the process characterized by a chemical change in which reactants are different from the products. Already you learned in 7th class the changes around us about physical change and chemical change. In physical change, you observed that states of matter is changed. For example, ice is converted into water and water is converted into water vapor when you are heating. It is a reversible process. In chemical change, day-to-day life, you observe milky changes into curd and rusting of iron. So these are irreversible process. And whereas physical change is reversible process. And in the chemical change, the reactants are different from the products and it occurs by the formation and breaking of chemical bonds. Let us know about types of chemical reactions. There are four types of chemical reactions. First one is chemical combination. Second one is decomposition reaction. Third one is displacement reaction and fourth one is double displacement reaction. Now let us know about chemical combination reaction. A reaction in which single product is formed from two or more reactants is known as chemical combination. Do you know, children, in Diwali festival you burn the crackers? Then what do you observe? When you burn the crackers, you will observe a white color powder is produced. So in crackers, what is present? Magnesium is present in the crackers. So when magnesium is burnt in oxygen, produces magnesium oxide. That white color powder is known as magnesium oxide. I am presenting one example. So here we are taking magnesium ribbon with tongues and it burns. Okay. So when it burns, it produces dazzling flame and produces white color powder. So here we are taking magnesium burnt in oxygen produces magnesium oxide. So here a single product is formed from two different types of atoms of elements. So this is chemical combination reaction. Let us see one more example, that is burning of coal. So when coal is burnt in oxygen, produces carbon dioxide and heat energy is liberated. See here, when carbon means nothing but coal. When burnt in oxygen, produces carbon dioxide and heat energy is liberated. So here also the carbon and oxygen, these are different atoms of different elements combined to form a single product. Let us perform one activity, children. In this activity, we are taking calcium oxide. Calcium oxide means quicklime. So the formula of quicklime is calcium oxide. Then we have to add water to this calcium oxide. So after adding, you touch the walls of the container. And what do you observe here? You will feel hotness of container. Then here in this reaction, when quicklime reacts with water, produces calcium hydroxide. That is nothing but slaked lime. And here, why we are feeling hotness of container? Means here the liberation of heat energy takes place. So when during the chemical reaction, if heat energy is liberated, that reactions are called exothermic. The product which is formed in the above reaction is used as whitewash. When we applied whitewash on the walls, so after some time, what do you observe? A white shiny product is formed on the walls. So when slaked lime reacts with carbon dioxide, produces calcium carbonate and water. These are the examples of chemical combination reaction. Let us go to second type of reactions, that is known as decomposition reaction. So a decomposition reaction in which a single compound breaks down into two or more simple products. There are three types of decomposition reactions. First one is thermal decomposition reaction, and second one is electrolytic decomposition reaction, and third one is photochemical decomposition reaction. If the reaction occurs in the presence of heat, that reactions are called thermal decomposition reactions. If the reaction occurs in the presence of electrolysis, that reactions are called electrolytic decomposition reactions. When the reaction occurs in the presence of sunlight, then that reactions are called photochemical decomposition reactions. In above all decomposition reactions, it requires energy in the form of heat, electrolysis, and sunlight. So in these reactions, the heat is observed. So these reactions are called endothermic reactions. Let us see some examples for thermal decomposition reactions. Children, what is thermal decomposition reactions? When decomposition reaction occurs in the presence of heat, is known as thermal decomposition reaction. See here, in this example, we are taking calcium carbonate, that is nothing but limestone. So when we are taking calcium carbonate in boiling tube and heat it, and observe what here some liberation of gas takes place. So here carbon dioxide is liberated. Then how can you identify that is carbon dioxide? You have to take the burning splinter and puts near the mouth of the test tube. It puts off the burning splinter and it turns lime water milky. So in this reaction, when calcium carbonate is heated, it forms calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. In this reaction, a single compound breaks down into two simple products. So this reaction occurs in the presence of heat. So this is known as thermal decomposition reaction. One more example, children. See here, heating of lead nitrate. So when lead nitrate is taken in a boiling tube and burn it, strongly heat it. So what happens here, reddish brown fumes are evolved due to liberation of nitrogen dioxide. The reddish brown fumes are nothing but nitrogen dioxide. So when lead nitrate is heated strongly, here forms lead oxide, nitrogen dioxide, and oxygen. Here three products are formed. So in this reaction, a single compound breaks down into two or more products. So this reaction occurs in the presence of heat. So this is called thermal decomposition reaction. Next, electrolytic decomposition reactions. Electrolytic decomposition reaction, in which the decomposition reaction is takes place in the presence of electrolysis, is known as electrolytic decomposition reaction. So let us perform one activity, children. Here we are taking a plastic mug, and you have to make two holes at the bottom of the mug, and you have to fix the two electrodes with rubber stoppers. Then you have to pour the water in this mug so that electrodes are immersed. Then you have to acidify the water with adding dilute, few drops of dilute H2SO4. Then the two test tubes filled with water, and you have to invert it over the electrodes. Then you have to connect the electrodes with 9 volts battery and switch on and observe the observations. So what do you observe here? Some gases are evolved from the electrodes. So check the volume of two test tubes. See, are they equal? No. Here, see, one test tube, it occupies more space compared to the other one. This test tube occupies twice of other test tube. So it indicates the liberation of oxygen and hydrogen. If you want, you have to check the test tubes with burning splinter. When you take the burning splinter and put near the mouth of the test tube, if it glows, it is oxygen. Then next, you have to test with the burning splinter with other test tube, and if you observe the pop sound, then that is hydrogen gas. So here in this reaction, water breaks down into hydrogen and oxygen in the presence of electrolysis. Here a single reactant breaks down into two simple products. So this reaction occurs in the presence of electrolysis. So this is known as electrolytic decomposition reaction. Next, photochemical decomposition. The decomposition reaction, when occurs in the presence of sunlight, then the reactions are known as photochemical decomposition reactions. Let us see one example, children. Here we are taking silver bromide in watch glass and keep it in sunlight. After some time, what do you observe here? The yellow color silver bromide changes into gray color material. That is nothing but silver, and liberation of bromine takes place here. So in this reaction, silver bromide breaks down into silver and bromine. This reaction occurs in the presence of sunlight. So this is known as photochemical decomposition reaction. Then third one is displacement reaction. The reaction in which one element displaces another element from its compound. Let us see some examples for displacement reactions. So when metal reacts with acids, liberates hydrogen gas. In this activity, here we are taking zinc granules in the conical flask and add dilute HCl, and immediately you have to tie the balloon at the mouth of conical flask tightly. Then after some time, what do you observe here? The balloon bulges out. So which gas is liberated, children, here? Hydrogen gas. So when zinc metal reacts with dilute HCl, produces zinc chloride and hydrogen. In this reaction, zinc displaces hydrogen from hydrochloric acid and occupy the place of hydrogen. So in this reaction, zinc is more reactive than hydrogen. So it displaces hydrogen. Then next, other reaction goes. See other example. Here we are taking copper sulfate solution in a test tube and put the iron nail. So before putting iron nail, you have to clean it with sandpaper. Then you have to keep the iron nail in copper sulfate solution, and after some time you observe. So what do you observe, children? Here the blue color of copper sulfate solution is fainted and the iron nail turns to brown color. So in this reaction, when iron reacts with copper sulfate, produces ferrous sulfate and copper. So in this reaction, iron displaces copper from copper sulfate solution and occupies the place of copper. In this reaction, iron is more reactive than copper. So it displaces copper. See some more examples, children. Here, zinc, when reacts with silver nitrate, produces zinc nitrate and silver. In this reaction, zinc is displaces silver nitrate, silver from silver nitrate, and occupies the place of silver. See in this example, lead is reacts with copper chloride and produces lead chloride and copper. In this reaction, lead is displaces copper and occupy the place of copper. So in this all above reactions, the one element is displaces the other element from its compound. So these are called displacement reactions. Then last one is double displacement reaction. If two reactants exchange their components, means both anion and cation, chemically and form two products, then it is called as double displacement reaction. Let us see some examples for double displacement reactions. Let us perform one activity, children, here. Here we are taking two test tubes, and in two test tubes you have to take two different solutions. In one test tube you have to take lead nitrate solution, and in another test tube you have to take potassium iodide solution, and you have to mix up these two solutions. So here, after mixing, what do you observe here? A yellow color precipitate is formed. So in this reaction, lead nitrate, when combines with potassium iodide, forms lead iodide and potassium nitrate. This, that yellow color precipitate is nothing but potassium iodide. In this reaction, see here we are taking two reactants. One is lead nitrate and other one is potassium iodide. In lead nitrate, potassium is, in lead nitrate, lead is cation and anion is nitrate. In this potassium iodide, potassium is cation and iodide is anion. See here, in this two components are exchanged. Here cations and anions are exchanged. So if both components are exchanged in two reactants, so this is known as double displacement reaction. See some other examples, children, here. When sodium sulfate reacts with barium chloride, forms barium sulfate and sodium chloride. A white color precipitate is observed in this reaction due to formation of barium sulfate. In this reaction also, one reactant is sodium sulfate and other one is barium chloride. In this compound here, in this reactant, sodium is cation and sulfate is anion. In this barium chloride, barium is cation and chloride is anion. So both the components of the reactants are exchanged and form barium sulfate and sodium chloride. See next example. When sodium hydroxide reacts with hydrochloric acid, forms sodium chloride and water. In this reaction also, both the components of the reactants are exchanged. See next example. When sodium chloride reacts with silver nitrate, forms silver chloride and sodium nitrate. Here, white precipitate is observed in this reaction due to formation of silver chloride. In this reaction also, here, if you take sodium chloride, cation is sodium and anion is chloride. In this silver nitrate, so silver is cation and nitrate is anion. So both the components of the reaction means here cations and anions are exchanged. So these are called double displacement reactions. What we have learned in this topic? Are you able to define the types of chemical reactions? And you need to predict the products of chemical reactions and construct a balanced chemical equations to represent reactions. I hope everyone understood well. So little assignment is giving from myself. Identify chemical reactions in your day-to-day life and construct chemical equations for that. The next, what happens when silver chloride is placed in the presence of sunlight and mention the type of reaction and products of the reaction.